Well, good afternoon. It is now 2 days post-storm, Dennis. I completely forgot to ring the builder yesterday about the roof situation. It's actually sunny at the moment, but it's been on and off, on and off, on and off. Showers, wind. It can't make its mind up. But there's one thing I also forgot to do yesterday, which was get up into the loft space up there and investigate. Find out exactly what extent the horror is up there. I had a quick cursory look on the night it was coming in and pouring down my bedroom walls, and it was wet up there. There was a particularly wet patch, and I did put a bucket on it, but I think the water was like seeping down the brickwork where the chimney would have been. So I don't think it was actually dripping. So I suppose the bucket was probably ineffective, but I didn't know what else to do. And I kind of felt like I should do something. So I did that. Should we go and have a look? Come on, we better stop putting it off, hadn't we? Tool at the ready. I'm rubbish at this. It was bangs. That's the knack, the middle bit. Oh yeah, look, that's where the catch is there. This ladder feels icy cold to the touch. Going on up. I hate going in the loft. Makes me feel a bit nervous. Oh, I forgot to put the light on. Hang on. I've got the vlogging light in my hand and the camera at the moment. Right. Is that going to work? Yes. I was a bit worried about the electrics up here with the water coming in. Doesn't look significantly worse over that. It's drying out, look. Can you see where it was? That's where I put the bucket. So the bucket has not collected anything. It's wet under where the bucket was. I probably stopped it drying out. So, yeah. Oh, it's all cobwebby. Let's have a feel how this is. It's quite all right over there, doesn't it? See, I've got this cladding, so I can't actually access it to tell the extent of the damage. Oh, that doesn't feel wet. Got a bit of mould by there. Hang on, I'll show you. That mould. It's not good. I absolutely do not want these to rot. I'd say that it's an emergency to get a builder in here and try to stop that rotting. Oh, nightmare. Do you know, I've got a feeling, and Dad reminded me of this the other day, that I was supposed to have roof vents put in here, according to the builder when he came and had a look before. And also what I was intending to do is to block up there, because that's actually next door. Not so much for security, because I'm not worried about them coming in. But in case there's a fire, you see, because if there was a fire next door, it would spread over here and give us less time to get out. And if we had a fire, it would spread over there and give them less time to get out, you see. So I did need to tackle that. But I must admit that when Izzy's funding fell through for college, like 3 weeks before the start of term in the summer, I forgot about everything else and just focused on homeschooling her and sorting out all the curriculum and everything. And that was a massive expense as well. So everything else went out the window. So, oh, I see there's only one bulb working. Look out of the four. I don't know if that's to do with the water coming in. I don't even know how to change those, but once the last one's gone, it'd be quite difficult to change it, wouldn't it? But I have got my vlogging light, look. There it is. I brought it up with me, you see, for lighting up here. I'm going to take a little series of photographs of this now. So I've got something that I could send a builder. But I think they're going to be really busy at the moment. I don't know what to do about that mould. What should I do about a mould? Should I squirt mould remover on it, or is that going to perish the wood? So I don't want to put some chemical on it that's going to actually wreck the timber beam. That's horrific. I'm really worried about that. Oh, thought of having to have that beam replaced. That sounds like a massive undertaking to me. I am wondering if the flashing's gone, because there's actually a chimney on my roof still, and it had some lead flashing around it, which might have looked a little bit suspect previously. But obviously we don't normally get a month's worth of rainfall in 48 hours like we have this time, so I think it tested it beyond its limits. Right, I'm going down. It's so awkward. I'm not the keenest on ladders, spindly little ladders, I must admit. I don't think I'm going to enjoy doing this when I'm older, like significantly older. Come on then, are you coming? I've just got off the phone to the builder. He was so reassuring. He said, no, don't worry, love, that's normal. All the buildings around here have got mould on the beams. Don't worry about it. Oh, no need to squirt it with mould remover. That's just domestic stuff. If you want to do something, paint it with creosote once the weather's broken and they've dried out. He said, that's antifungal, that'll sort it out. But anyway, he's going to come at the weekend and have a look. And he said, yes, he is very, very busy at the moment. I said, don't prioritise this, honestly, because, you know, this is really insignificant compared to what the most of the people are going through. But he said, no, it's okay, I live locally, I'll pop in on Saturday morning. So that was nice of him. I've kind of been juggling that with something else at the moment. I'm trying to sort somebody's music parts out for them at the moment as well, doing a little bit of transposing because they didn't have access to the same software as I do. So I don't even know what country she's in, to be honest. Some sort of course, I think they're doing. I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to get on with it. Right, I've sorted that. Now, he made pancakes earlier. Where's the batter? I was thinking, I just fancy pancake. Oh, bless her, look at that. Well, I never. She's growing up. She's put it in the fridge. Wonderful. Look at this lovely melamine bowl I had for Christmas from IKEA. You can even take the top off and see what's in it if you want. Look at that. Marvellous. Izzy puts sugar in her mix and I don't, that's the difference. So you're kind of forced to have something sweet with Izzy's, whereas I might have spinach and cheese on mine. Smells good though. Oh, it smells really good. Izzy does them American style, thick and like not very wide. Well, this is more like a UK one, isn't it? My phone's on fire today. It probably means I've just mucked up the transposing the sheet music thing again. Let's see. I'm not used to doing it. That's fine. It's looking like a giant crumpet at the moment. Look at all those little holes. Probably because it's self-raising flour. You're supposed to use self-raising or plain for pancakes. We just use whatever's in the cupboard. Now, I'm not an adventurous flipper. I don't do any of this, like, ooh, that, yeah, that's quite brown. Oh, man. You must think I burn all my food. I don't burn everything. I'm better at some things than others. Of golden syrup. I'm sure butter would be nice as well, but I think that's overkill really on the calorie front. Bit of that. Looking forward to that now. Izzy's just been downstairs marking her own maths and she's gone up to do some now, and while she's doing that I'm going to go and practice my flute down in Flute Cave. It's the evening now and I am attempting to make these giant turkey legs. I'm just going to make it up as I go along. My plan is to make it up. I have a vague picture in my mind. It's kind of making me fancy fish and chips. I'm rather hoping there's going to be a moment of magic when it's all squishes together and it looks right. Maybe I'm being a bit ambitious. Luckily, I had a sellotape dispenser for Christmas. It makes it easier. This is definitely a two-person job. You can see me running out to get more sellotape tomorrow. Oh, the bottle's falling out the middle. Ta-da! Okay, that's not mine. Needs a bit of refinement, I think. So this is what I'm aiming for. And it currently looks like this. There's a prince under there. Oh, sorry. I've smothered him in cling film. Okay, so it turns out I might have made my turkey legs a little too giant. I checked in with the bosses. Oh, that's
probably them now. And with a little video of Isabel modelling the giant turkey leg so they could get perspective on the size. And apparently it's twice as big as it should be.
So I've made one half the size and they said that's okay. And I can tell you what, that was a lot easier to make as well. I just used a plastic bottle and stuffed a few bits of newspaper in it and wrapped up in cling film. Easy.
Right, well, on that rather ridiculous note, I'm going to end the vlog and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!